At this time, though, we want to turn the program over to Jay Don from Lionel.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Can you hear okay? Let's stand back a little bit. Wow, what a great crowd. It's great when we come here and we get real excited when we see the lobby is so full of people, because that's what we like. We're so excited about what we want to present to you guys, so the bigger the crowd, the happier we are. And I want to thank all of you for being here at our seminar. It seems like these 6 months just click by so fast, but that's okay. We always have a good time when we come. And so we just welcome all of you and glad that you're here. We want to invite all of you to go to our booth at the Orange Hall. As you can imagine, we can only bring a token of the items that we have that we want you to see to this particular venue because of the space constraints that we have. And you'll be able to see a lot of our products being operated and going through their paces. The first thing that I always like to do when I'm here is to make a presentation to the museum, because we think very highly of the museum carrying on the history of the toy train hobby, especially to the younger generations that visit this location throughout the year. When we're not here, there are visitors coming here at all times, and of course we like for them to see our products here. And so, Charlie, on behalf of all of us at Lionel Trains, we want to present this new, beautiful conventional classics Rock Island AA set, Alco set to you on behalf of all the employees at Lionel, and I know that it will find a real prominent place to be displayed.
Definitely. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. You're very welcome. Yeah, right. And the box is back there.
Okay.
To put it in. Okay, what I'd like to do now is introduce you to the folks that we have here from Lionel. Bill Lito is from our marketing department. He'll be making a presentation. Matt Ashba sends his regards. There were some family commitments that he was committed to and was not able to make it this time, but he does send his regards. Also, I'd like to introduce Joe Fia, that's the manager of our special events and shows and so forth from our New York office. Ryan Kunkel, he's the guy that handles our Facebook and internet and all of that for us, and we're glad to have Ryan here, and I believe that's it. So at this time, we want to start talking to you about some of our new stuff, and so I'll ask Bill Lito if he'll come up.
Should we switch sides, maybe?
I'll hand it to you.
I'll be on the engineer side today, I guess, and that way you can reach things out.
The fireman.
Yeah, there you go. Thank you all so much for joining us today. Thank you for sticking around, and pardon our little delay there as we got set up. It's good to see our friends and familiar faces, and I work with Matt and Ramey back in Michigan, and as Jadon said, Matt couldn't make it. Jadon was in Chesterfield, and we told him that I would be here with him, and he said, yeah, we got the band back together. Mm-hmm. So. We definitely do. So we've got some products to show for you. As he said, can't bring it all, wouldn't fit in the rental car, but I think we about filled it up to maximum capacity. I don't think we could fit one more thing.
I have to stand back a little bit, I think.
All right, there we go. Gonna show some highlights from C2, which is now online and coming out. You know, they say you can't be everything to everybody, but I know that Lionel is a lot of things to a lot of people. So what I'm going to try and do right now is go through the line and show the different segments and what we've got to offer from the traditional collector, kids, and those of us who are modeling scale things in our basement. And we'll start right where we started, kind of in the beginning. We have here the Berkshire locomotive. That's offered in the two Berkshire sets. The sets are going to be in the booth at the fairgrounds, so be sure to stop by and take a look at those. And Ryan, we've also got the operating merchandise car, the other kind of newly tooled piece that I brought along. Be sure to come by, get a closer look at both of those pieces. Again, we're looking at a product that goes all the way back to the 1940s. This guy's newly tooled in the frame as a single piece, new mechanism, but you might have seen it operate on the internet. I think maybe it was Ryan who had that up there. You can watch the boxes go. Now we're going to switch gears in rolling stock. And
it feels very heavy.
Yeah, it's a solid piece.
Very heavy.
Yeah, for sure. So now we're going to look at some scale rolling stock with the double door and single door round top boxcars, 1930s. You'll recognize the Pennsylvania's X31. And again, you know, as with every business, trying to maximize capacity and efficiency. So we've got the round roof for ease of manufacturing to get a little bit more headroom in those cars. Now we're going to fast forward significantly up to.
We need to switch because I need to pass over here.
Now I'm the fireman. And we're going to put on the steam with the 89-foot auto carrier. So we're looking at 1970s to present.
Yeah, there we go,
Bob says. This was a tricky one to. Thank you. Take a bow. We got a scale piece, new tooling. This was some tricky tooling to manufacture with all the holes. I don't know if you can see it, but as Jadon's moving it around, you can kind of get a sense of the silhouette of what would be in the car. Now, 89 foot 9 inches on the prototype. This feels awful close to that. If it were configured for three decks, you know, you would expect to have like 18 cars in there. We've got the two-deck configuration there. One thing to be on the lookout for is more road numbers, and then we're going to follow that up with even more road names and products in 2013. Okay, now we're going to move on to the command speeder. We're going from a very large piece of rolling stock to a very small one. So MOW equipment that's been on the rails for a long, long time, and something that we've offered now with command control, so you can have a nice, affordable little piece of motive power to put on your track and cruise around. Great little piece. Okay, so Lionel has done a series of what-if locomotives and rolling stock for a long time now. Several years ago, you'll remember, the Union Pacific came out with their Heritage Series, and that was very successful. Lionel had a CSX Heritage Series as well. What I want to show for you right now is the BNSF Santa Fe Heritage piece.
Well, this is heavy, too.
It is heavy, too.
Yeah,
I'll catch you if you fall.
Yeah.
So we have that example. Earlier this year, we announced the Norfolk Southern Heritage Series. And we're going to start with the newly tooled body for our ES44. It'll be a plastic body. And you've probably seen the suggested retail price at $549. So it's got legacy rail sounds, electrocouplers, smoke. Very typical of our high-end, fully featured locomotives there. Ryan, let's take a look at the Jeep 9. We've got a Rock Island example. We brought along this guy to just let you know that Lionel has a Jeep 9, which is not a Jeep 7 with dynamic brake. We vary the dynamic brake component with the road name. This particular one has the higher spark arresters on it. The louvers for a Jeep 9. So a great addition, gotta love a Jeep. Oops. I'll put in a battery for you while we're standing here too. Okay, so we've gone from really little, let's go to really big with the the Centipede A units. So now we have really big things and really little things. This is one of the biggest. This is 24 inches of die-cast metal. It has two electrocouplers, two motors, two speakers, rotating fans. Is it vision for a single unit? The answer is no. The vision pieces were AA sets with the sound kind of adjusted through both of the units for kind of a mix. This is obviously one unit, so it doesn't have that same mix. Ryan's holding the NDM single unit here as well.
There's person.
So again, electric couplers both ends still has two speakers, rotating fans, very heavy. Okay, let's go on to a little bit of power and control. We'll look at the cab 1L and the base 1L. Legacy control system here. The form factor you're probably familiar with, but this is communicating on the legacy platform. If you've already got the legacy base, you don't need this. But if you're looking for an economical and easy way to add a remote, or if you're just getting started, we have the simple remote here. Obviously, it's limited because it doesn't have the touch screens and the display, okay? So it's gonna have operation that you're familiar with from a few years ago, but it does have quilling whistle, which you do with the whistle button. So that feature is available there. I know that's a favorite, very cool to have. They're blue, as you can see. So we've got those. Let's take a quick look at power. We introduced the GW180 transformer. It's a 180-watt power supply. It uses a 180-watt powerhouse, which, of course, you all approved. It's got the circuit breaker. Familiar form factor here, two-channel output. This is 180 watts. It has the track and accessory that's adjustable, as you're familiar with. So great middle-of-the-road transformer that we're able to offer there. Okay, Ryan, we're going to get a little crazy here with a variety of cars that we brought to show. Made in USA, we have done a lot of box cars. Thomas Kincaid, some American favorites, Coca-Cola, Elvis. That's one as well. The 2012 Christmas boxcar is also made in the United States. So glad to offer those.
I would like to add that, you know, we introduced the Presidential boxcar series last year, and they're completely sold out. There were some folks that were telling us that, oh, you know, you guys don't make these in the United States. You make the parts in China, and you bring them over here, and you assemble them, and then you say they're made. That's not true. I want to clear this up. These cars are made from scratch in the United States, and they come with metal frames, sprung trucks, and they're a high-quality box car, and they're all made at a factory in Michigan, not too far away from Chesterfield. In fact, those folks used to do some business for us on a contractual basis when the factory was in the United States. So they're made here in the United States.
Also glad to say, it's not stopping there, folks. We've got the Presidential series you can see that we've added on with more box cars. Stay tuned for additional car types. Stay tuned for additional decoration and themes that we're gonna bring to the Made in the USA series. This is a really neat thing, and glad to bring it here. Next up, we'll look at the Thomas and Friends remote set, which is wedged in the bottom there. We first showed this at York in April at the fairgrounds, and now we're back. This is how the box will be for the train set. We're gonna have the setup and running in the booth, so you can stop by. I would encourage you, grab the remote, give it a shot. It's very fun, great for kids. You know, be on the lookout for even more in this this product line with this platform. It's working really well for what we want it to do. So be on the lookout
there. Let me just add one thing here about this. It's important that you come by and see this operate for a couple of reasons. One, while this locomotive looks identical to the one that we have in our transformer set, inside it's a completely different locomotive. In fact, you'll see when you're in the booth that we're pulling like not only these cars, but we're pulling three additional expansion packs, Thomas the Tank expansion pack. This thing has amazing pulling power at creeping speeds. And with this remote, you can control the forward, reverse. You have a talk button that top of them hat says all aboard, you have a whistle, and you have the chuffing sound of a steam locomotive. So it really is impressive. So I do invite you guys to see this thing in action in our booth. And the range with this remote is just fantastic. I could go out in the parking lot out there and blow the whistle on this thing. So
yeah, I'm sure you
so
could.
Come by and take a look at it.
Yeah. Another thing that this offers, sound. We have the whistle, we have the bell, we have background sounds. This adds another dimension of play. We have Sir Topham Hatt as a all aboard announcement with the center button. The other thing that it does, for those who aren't familiar with it, is we get rid of all the wires and the terminals and connections, and we go with a really simple power jack right from the wall to a simple track section. It's one easy, you know, pop the wire in and you're in business. So, you know, no excuses, no intimidation. It's ready to go.
No transformer. It's all controlled from the remote. No transformer.
Yeah. Okay, let's switch over to, while we're talking about train sets, let's look at the NASCAR train set. Okay. In the latest catalog here, Lionel, I don't know if you can hold that up, is introducing six train sets featuring some of your favorite drivers, coming with die-cast cars. As you know, we've got great inroads and a great opportunity to share with our friends at NASCAR, as Lionel's been involved with Lionel NASCAR collectibles and making these available here as well with some, you know, great brands there as well, including M&M's that we're showing here today. Do you have anything to add to that guy, Jadon?
No, I just think they're attractive. Well, we are using the name brand drivers, the biggest drivers in the sport. I think there's six sets based on the Pennsylvania Flyer style set at that same price range. And they are limited in numbers, so they're all very attractive. And again, they all will come with the particular NASCAR driver, die-cast, two die-cast, actually there's a flat car for this, right?
I think that's the configuration.
Okay.
Yep.
And the 1/43rd scale, all die-cast metal cars, and several of the drivers, depending on the races, they have two different, and sometimes three different art schemes, deco schemes on their cars. In this case, this is the M&M car. Which driver is that?
Kyle Busch,
there you go. We've got some NASCAR fans in here. So these would be real neat. And they're in the catalog. And by the way, the catalogs will be in the booth. We just released that catalog. So many of you may not have that catalog, but you will be able to get it in our booth when we open up tomorrow.
For free.
We tried to get it cheaper than that, but we didn't know how to do it.
All right, let's switch over to American Flyer. We'll start off with the PAAA set. PA's starting in the mid-40s, decorated for the Texas Special, fully featured with legacy system, rail sounds, electrocouplers. Be sure to take a closer look, because this is a gorgeous paint scheme. Along with the diesels, we have the all-new scale SD70 ACE. Look for the Norfolk Southern Heritage units. Legacy rail sounds, they have speed control, two electrocouplers, scalar traditional wheels. So a great piece. I think there's going to be a decorated version of the locomotive in the booth at the fairground. So Flyer fans, be on the lookout for that.
This is an early sample, and this is the way they come in a lot of times, just for our inspection before they're decorated.
So popular car type since the 1960s, the cylindrical hopper. Again, kind of like the undecorated, unpainted SD70, we've got the tank to the hopper there, and some of the catwalks and hatches. Keep in mind, it's all super glued together at this point, just for us to kind of show you. And we've got the O-gauge cousin here, just for comparison. So we've got those being offered in just a variety of road names, going along with the Norfolk Southern Heritage series and even more. scale wheels with flyer couplers, and it's got a coupler pocket so that you can change out those couplers as well, if you're so inclined. Another one we've got for you, for flyer fans, is the 2882Y3. Great USRE locomotive, 1919. This is just a really fun locomotive to offer just because of the road names we're able to do with the history of the locomotive. Ordered by Virginian, but canceled. Went to the Norfolk and Western, then Santa Fe, Pennsylvania, and Union Pacific also had them, just dealing with wartime power shortages and a great prototype, lots of detail. Be sure to check it out. Legacy rail sounds, American Flyer speed control, wireless tether. Do take a look there. So I don't think we could fit any more in our car, but we have a lot at the booth. A few things to let you know that we have there. Two of them are not actual products, but they're people. We've got John Zahornicki joining us in the main booth in our usual location at the Orange Hall. He's going to be introducing and showing what he's calling the LCS concept. That's layout control software. So you've got your cab 2 to operate your locomotives. It's designed to do that. It gives you, you know, the feedback and the display. Take a look at what you're going to be able to do with additional technology, making it more interactive to control your whole layout. We have a modular booth in the Orange Hall where we're showing the modular projects that we've been working on. And I think Ryan's going to be over there to show you the standard size and what you're able to do in that small amount. Just a neat way to get more and more people involved in the hobby who maybe don't have the space. Also, just like we have here, great friends and a really good time as everybody gets to come together. So hopefully that'll facilitate that as well. For those of you with service questions or for parts, we've got Mike Reagan back again, and he's there as well. And Jadon, do you have anything else?
I think that's it. We will open it up for questions and answers, and hopefully we have the answers. Yes, sir.
This is an obscure question. Are there any plans for an additional runs
of the what?
Okay, the question was, are there any plans for additional runs of the Evolution engine? There are none announced. That's a definite possibility. I'd like to see it, too.
Well, you know, you can't find one even on eBay.
Yeah. Yeah, they went away quickly. It is. Thank you. We'll take that as a suggestion.
Yes, sir.
Bill.
Hi.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What's the status of the American Flyer Defender set?
That's a good question for Ramey. I know there's been a lot of work with the tools. Ask him at the booth.
Yes, sir.
The question was, he's looking for additions, expansions, more to do with the legacy platform. I think this is the York for you. Are you going to the fairgrounds?
Yes.
Okay. Please be sure to stop by and take a look at what John Zahornicki is showing in terms of operating your whole layout, basically an iPad component so that you're able to throw switches and things, track sensors. Okay. Good question. Let's talk about that a little bit more offline, and then also John will be able to help you out. Other questions? Hi. Okay, be sure, the question was, when is John putting on the demonstrations? At this point, I would invite you to stop by the booth and take a look at when they're there. I don't know that there are any published presentation times. We've got John Zahornicki and John Ricks. They've got their layout that'll be, if you're facing the display to the left, you'll be able to see their layout there. I think they're going to put out a sign if they're not there continuously for what they're planning for the day. And I think they're just going to kind of play it by ear and see how traffic goes.
They'll be in the booth when we open tomorrow.
Yep.
So, yeah. Yes, sir.
Is that Thomas the Tank? Is that a battery operated train
then? No, it is not. It has an electrical plug-in. It goes straight to a plug-in track. It bypasses the transformer altogether. And another good point about that, it also lowers the price considerably when you take the transformer out.
What is the price?
$159.99. Yes, sir.
Can you run it on your regular layout?
You can. Yes, you can. You can put it right up on Dad's or Granddad's layout and still operate it. It works kind of like Legacy. You just power the track up. It stays powered up. And it doesn't move until you address it with the remote.
Yep. So you
can put it right on a Legacy layout. Same concept. As long as the track is powered up, you can operate it. Same thing.
Question?
Are you going to do some more closing steam engines? And are you thinking about putting the close coupling on all your combined cars?
Thank you for bringing that up. Oh, you caught me in a omission. Thank you. Yeah, he's saying money. His question was use of close coupling. Definitely an option for steam locomotives, and I don't know that there is a rule of thumb that we're using there. I can't give you a really easy answer on that, but yes, that's technology that's on the table. Here's what I forgot to mention. For a car as long as this, we have used the close coupling system here too. So you'll be familiar with how that works from the steam locomotives as well. And just the other day, we were watching a set of these serpentine through some switches and curves on our track, and it's pretty cool. It really does the job, and I know why you like it. So yeah, definitely on the table.
Hey, Bob.
How is that set coming? Is the Motor City set on its way? Do you have any details on that?
We have a shipping schedule, but we don't have it here with us. It's in the booth, and I can't remember exactly when that ship's scheduled.
October. I just don't know if that's real or not.
I would say it's close, judging from the state here. Yeah. If it's October, November,
yeah, so
you know,
it's
late this year.
Last
what was that?
It's showing December on your last.
Okay.
Oh, moved to December? Okay.
I'm not telling you which year.
Yes, sir. That's right.
We want to thank you for doing the additional run on the add-on car for the Hogwarts Express. That was really a nice thing to have put that in the catalog.
Welcome. Well, we heard you. We heard you. A lot of people had asked for the additional cars, so it's kind of like the Blue Comet. Where
are you going to get
the Blue Comet's back in the catalog with a different cab number? But we had people. You know, we sold out very quickly last year, and so we had a lot of requests for the Blue Comet and cars. So it's back in the catalog, but as a new item with a new cab number.
Are you going to run the two-pack cars, the add-on cars for it, Blue Comet?
Yeah, they're in there, aren't they?
No.
The two cars, they're not in the current catalog? Okay, I don't know if we're going
to... Bob, I'd have to check for you.
Yeah, I thought Matt said he was thinking about it.
Yes, sir.
I'm probably not the only grandparent in the audience here, so my question about Thomas the Train is that going to be available this Christmas? Yeah.
Yeah, they're out there. Yep.
But is it going to be available by that time?
We've already shipped them.
Yeah.
They're shipped. Yep. They're out. Dealers should have them.
Dealers should have them.
Oh, yeah.
Go buy one tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah. They're already selling. Any more questions?
Oh, we have one over here. Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
I've never seen a 1950 roll around, but not a 1953.
Let me take that back as a suggestion. Her suggestion was the catalog artwork for the 1953 Lionel catalog on a boxcar. Thank you. Yeah, let me take that back.
My husband.
Great. Thank you. Super.
What is the radius on that? 072 on that Parker?
This is O around the world.
Not quite. Yeah, it's 54.
Oh, 54, yeah. Yeah.
And again, with the coupling system, we're able to do some good things for a lot of people with those little bit tighter curves. Yes, sir. Okay, so the question was, Lionel's done the John Bull and another, a number of really significant trains of
Heritage
series times past. Are we doing more? We haven't announced anything. Always, a possibility. I'm going to ask you a question, though. What would you like to see if you could pick the next one?
I would like to see the Reading Bicycle.
Okay, the Reading Bicycle. Thank you.
And also, I would like to see the 1223.
In the 1223 from the museum. Okay, thank you for your suggestions.
Any more? If not, we'll see all you guys hopefully tomorrow in the booth. We'll be there 12 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.